chisel hearth needed now. Please stand clear of the doors. Door closing.
It's not my fucking night.
Got that, mate.
Yeah.
Stay fucking still.
Tough day.
You can say that. Thanks for, well, thanks. Thanks.
Oh, I'm happy to help my fellow man.
Oh, bollocks. My phone.
Yeah, she gave you a right good kicking, didn't she? I gave you a right good bleeding pasting. Yeah.
Oh, and my wallet. Fuck.
Oh, no. Oh dear. But I shall expunge you from your predicament, young man, and then you can buy me a drink.
I'd love to, but
I know somewhere where I can get you a cup of something warm and wet. Heave-ho!
Nice tea.
I knew it! It is, isn't it? The best tea! Did you hear that, Stefania? He says it's the best tea in all of our London town.
I'm sure it tastes better because you didn't pay for it again.
Don't be like that. Look, look, look at his little face.
So, what brings you to these dirty streets, my young lad?
John.
My young John.
Just John.
Well, just John. Dustin Miller. Dustin Miller. No. The Old Vic. Love Joy. Ho Season's holiday advertisement. Oh, I'm surprised you don't recognize me. After all the years I've performed there. Horrific dance upon me.
So what, you used to be an actor?
Used to be? It is the work that stopped, dear boy, not I. Because my agent was an imbecile. I would say to him, I don't want any rubbish. I want the classics, something with
heft. It's nigh on impossible when you've got fuckers like McKellen and Gambon showing you their cock for tuppence. They'd do Twanky and Catford if the price was right. You know, once I said to him, I said, get me Chekhov. You know what he said?
And the Star Trek.
Philistine. To have no integrity is the worst thing you can say about somebody.
Anyway, oh, shit. Sorry, I just forgot about my phone. Of all the nights.
No, don't worry. I'm sure Stefania would lend you hers. If you need to call a mini taxi Uber thingy.
To be honest, mate, it's not a cab I'm looking for. It's an excuse. Something she didn't get her hands on. I'm supposed to be flying out to see my father today. In the Bahamas.
Ooh, the Bahamas. C'est très exotique, hein? I'd have never left here. This place. It's a wonderful place. Back in the days. Sweaty neon and throbbing rhythms back when I was high on hope and exuberance and the promise of promiscuity, of course. Now it's more mediocrity than mayhem. The drab has taken over from the dramatic. Where is the lust? It's now lots of latte.
Look, to tell you the truth, mate, I'm not sure I'm even gonna go. You know, yesterday I was having tea with my auntie and, you know, my flights were booked, my bags were packed, and then 3 hours later. Yeah. Maybe this is all karma for not having the balls to face it. What I seem to do these days is run away from everything. I'm fed up of everything, of everyone telling me how I should live, you know? My whole life, I have played by the rules because that's what my family expects. God, I know what I should be doing, I just can't seem to bloody do it.
I'm sorry, have I missed something?
I can't tell my father that it's all gone to pot. You know, my job is shit. My girlfriend's about to dump me. I've got more payday loans than I do friends. And now... No, even this tea is shit. Sorry. All he wants to do is hear how much of a success I am, you know? Like, how great everything is. I can't tell him the truth.
Ah, yes. The truth is really pure and never simple.
Look, I'm sorry, mate. I never really speak about this with anyone, to be honest, and now I find myself somehow in a cafe at stupid o'clock, letting it all out to some paddy that I don't know.
I know a place we can go for a few hours.
If it's all the same to you, mate, I'd rather just sit here.
This ain't a bloody bus shelter. I said one tea on the house, that's it. If you want to stay, buy something.
Coming with me. You won't regret it.
Fuck's sake, come in quickly before anybody sees you. Don't sit down till I put a sheet down.
It's hardly becoming.
I told you before, if you want to sit on my soft furnishings, get yourself down to shelter and get those fucking clothes washed.
I've been banned from the shelter.
How do you get banned from a shelter?
A disagreement over a leg of lamb. So, my sweet-natured gentleman of fortune, how have you been?
What do you want, Dustin?
Do I have to have a reason to visit?
Yeah.
In this case, it's not me. It's not. John here is having a horrific night.
Well, that's self-evident. He's with you, so...
That being the case, we... He needs a place of refuge, a sanctuary, if you will, whilst we await the sunrise.
I missed the last train and got mugged, so if I could hang out here, it'd really help.
Okay, you've got kind eyes, and I'm a sucker for a sob story, but only till the trains start running.
Shit, I've got to take this.
You make yourself at home, you don't.
Lord Pembroke, how the devil are you?
Ooh. Well, I take it back. This is a nice place.
And I will have a nice place soon, too. Yes, I know I've made some poor financial decisions over the years, and I once dreamed of a tax haven in the Cayman Islands, but of course the reality was a caravan in Cavey Island! Do you dare doubt that I, Dustin Miller, a man whom Baz Bamick Boy once described as the freshest thing to hit the West End since the refurbishment of the Piccadilly Circus Underground Bogs, that I do not have the requisite chops to rise once again from the ashes to star?
Well, I...
But of course, you've not seen me perform, have you? You've not seen me! Well, I have to rectify that! Tell Bolingbroke, for young methinks his stance, that every step he takes upon my land is dangerous treason. He has come to open the testament of bleeding war, but ere the...
How did you two meet?
The first time I saw him on stage, he was playing Biff in Death of a Salesman. Though he was a lot younger then, as was I.
Oh, stop it.
Thank you.
Sorry.
It was years later when I met him properly, and he was married to Becky then. And he was in love with her too. She wasn't ticking his box, if you know what I mean.
Oh.
We became friendly long before she became ill. But he was with me the night she died, and I think that's part of what broke him.
Damn, that sounds awful.
Yeah, well, guilt's a bitch, and she knows where you live. He lost his home, his job, his so-called friends. Wish I'd done more at the time to help. But eventually he just fell out of the system, out of society, and nobody tried to stop him or catch him. So he just kept on falling.
Ça faisait bien longtemps qu'on ne vous avait pas vu, tous les deux. Un matin de printemps, vous aviez disparu, tous les deux. Dans la chambre est resté le lit tout ouvert, par vous deux. Où déjà ce soir-là, vos corps se sont offerts.
What?
Just coincidence. I'm supposed to be flying out there in a few hours.
Shit, have you packed?
I'm not sure I'm even going.
Why? It looks beautiful. What about you booked?
My father lives there, in a place called Hopetown.
Sounds lovely.
He's dying. We're not sure how long he's got left, so
This could be my last chance to... What did you mean when you said you wished you could do more for Dustin?
Thing is, this is a business. It's a job. Some punters you like, some you hate, some you even fancy, but they're all just clients. And occasionally, rarely, you'll meet someone who draws you in, especially if they're good people. Dustin is good people. Sometimes I just wonder if things had been different if we'd met outside of work. Shouldn't you be on the way to the airport?
I keep telling myself that. You know, I keep thinking about Dad, and when I was young, he was always there for me, you know? He always made time. He held me off on my first bike and taught me how to fish. He picked me up on his shoulders when I fell over. And then when Mum died, like a switch turned off. You know, he became distant, cold even. I guess I was too young to understand it at the time, but I did know that things were never the same again. And then he went off to live in Hopetown and left me to be brought up by my aunties. There's not a day that goes by that I don't feel the pressure of expectation from him. I'm supposed to be the success story of the family, right? Like, good job, good wife, good house. Make Mum proud. I was supposed to be everything that was out of his reach when he lived in London in the 70s. And now that he's dying, I don't know how to tell him that I failed. I know it sounds so self-indulgent, but it's not really about me, you know? My dad thinks I've got the world on my feet.
Why would he think that?
Because that's what I've been telling him for the past 5 years. And now if I tell him that none of it's true, what if it kills him? So, like a responsible adult, instead of facing it, I get drunk.
Cheers to that.
So, what do I do?
I don't know. I'm a pimp, not a cocking priest. Jesus, look at the three of us. Dustin there fell through the gap. I'm living in the shadows and you're hanging on by your fingernails. But no matter how pushed down or beaten up or fucked up we get, we've got to keep on picking ourselves up because one day it might be our day, you know? The downtrodden, the wretched, the forgotten.
Do you think?
We're all getting fucked, sweetie. The trick is to keep your eyes open while it's happening. It's the only way you'll learn anything. Listen. You may have been lying to your dad to help his feelings, but don't mistake your kindness for weakness. You're not a failure, John. You're seeing another sunrise and you've got your eyes open. And in my book, at least, that makes you a success.
Do you mind if I borrow your phone?
Sure. I saw all the things that I love in this world. The work, food, time to sit and smoke. I looked at the pen and thought, what the hell am I grabbing this for? Why am I trying to become what I don't want to be? And all I want is out there, waiting for me. The minute I say I know who I am.
Hello, Dad?
Right! Who fancies a nice cup of tea?
this trip